Good morning everyone. Welcome back to your online class. In our last video we have discussed about ratio. If you remember, what is ratio? Ratio is the relationship of two things of same kind. But today our topic is proportion. You can see in your books exercise 6.2, proportion. So what is proportion? The comparison between the two ratios of same kind. If you can see the definition in ratio, it was written the relationship. Instead of relationship, now here comes the comparison between the two ratios of the same kind. The kind should be same. Okay, now let us take one example. A ratio B, this is the sign of proportion. C ratio D. Okay, we can call this is to also. A is to B, proportion C is to D. Now in your last video, we have discussed that these are known as the terms, first term, second term. But here instead of two, there are now four terms, first term, second term, third term, fourth term. Now the first term and our fourth term, see I have put a tick over here, first and the fourth. These two terms, I have made this arrow also, this is known as extremes. And our middle terms, second term and third term, these two known as the means. Center one means and the far one extremes. So here in our whole exercise, we are going to use only one formula. Product of extreme is equal to product of means. If product of extreme means these two product and these two products, these both are equal, it means that our sum is in proportion. And what do you mean by product? Product means when we multiply any two numbers, the answer we get, that answer is known as the product. So if I multiply A and D on one side and B and C on the other side, and if the answer comes same, then it is known as the proportion. And if it is not same, it means that the numbers are not in a proportion. Understood? Now students, open your books. Exercise 6.2, page number 86. Our first sum is check whether in proportion or not. Whether these numbers given in commas, they are in proportion or not. So what we will do, we will take the first term and the last term. We will multiply that two terms and the second and the third term. Then we will see their answers. See, if I multiply 6 into 4 is 24. Similarly, 21 into 12 is 252. Now see, if we see these two answers that are not same. Because these two are not same, so our answer is no. These are not in proportion. Now take one another example. 30, 15, 40, 20. Same way, I have taken the first term and the last term together. See, second and the third term together, again multiply 30 into 20 is 600, 15 into 40 is 600. Both answers are same. So children, as both are same, so my answer is yes. Yes, these numbers are in proportion. Now coming to your second one. See, find x. Now here the sum is given in commas, but here they have, the sum is in ratio. See, 6 ratio 9, or you can say 6 is to 9, proportionate x is to 15. Now children, here we have to find the value of x. As I have just now told you that there is one formula, product of extreme is equal to product of mean. Now children, you have to see where is x. Now see, my these two far away numbers, these are extreme. Which are in the middle? The center numbers are means. Now where is x? X is in the mean. So whether x is in mean, whether x is in extreme, that one we have to write here. Now x is in means, so I will write a product of means. Okay, product of extreme I write in the other side. So mean is a 9 multiplied by x and extreme 6 multiplied by 15. So you can multiply also and do the cutting, otherwise you leave it as it is. And here 9 into x, so any number multiplied on one side when it goes to other side. When 9 goes to the other side of equals to, what it becomes? Multiply will become divide. Now do the cancellation here with the table of 3. 3 into 2 is 6, 3 into 3 is 9, 3 into 1 is 3, and 3 into 5 is 15. Now what is remaining, children? 5 and 2. So 5 multiplied by 2 is 10. So my x is 10. Now children, I will tell you one cross check over here. How to cross check this? See, 15 multiplied by 6. If you remember the table of 15, 15 multiplied by 6 is 90. Okay, now if I put this 10 here in the value of x, 9 multiplied by 10 is 90. It means my answer is correct. Fine. Now coming to the third one, find the fourth proportional. See children, first of all, you see the question carefully. Whatever we have to find, that thing we have to suppose x. Okay, let the fourth proportional be x. 3 are given, first term, second term, third term is given, but we are not having the fourth term. So I suppose that is to be x. See, first, second, third, fourth, I have written x. Okay, now rest of the method is same. Now see one thing more, where is x? X is in my extreme now, see. So what I will write here, product of extreme is equal to product of means. Rest is same. X will come to this side, here also, okay, 18 into x, x will come here, 54 into 6. Now it is multiply here, when it goes to other side, it will become divided. 18 into 1 is 18, 18 into 3 is 54. And when we multiply 3 and 6, we will get 18. Okay, understood children, how to find x, how to find the fourth proportional, and how to find whether it is in proportion or not. I have taken two sums here, one here, rest are same, okay. Some I will give you in the campus care, rest you have to try yourself. Okay. Now children, see the fourth one. Fourth is, find the third proportion. Children, where there are two terms given, then the third term we will suppose x. But there is one change here. What is the change here? That instead of taking four terms, here the second term is repeated, means our b is repeated. Okay, see what is the second term? 4 is repeated, so we write 4 twice. So here we write here 2 is to 4, proportion 4 is to x. The third term comes here. Okay, 4 is second term is repeated twice. Now this is the first term, these two second, and this is the third term. Okay, same way, where is the x? X is in extreme, so we will take in this side, and 4 into 4 this side means. Now multiply these two, divide with 2, so we will get here 8. Now I want to cross check my answer, children. So 4 into 4 is 16. If here comes 8, this 8 will go here. 8 into 2 is 16. It means my answer is correct. Now next one is, find the mean proportion. Now children, as you know, we are having 4 terms. Okay, so here we will suppose the mean proportion is x. Out of the 4 terms, the second and the third term is known as the mean. See, in every formula we have written center to second and third one is mid values are mean. So we take the mean as x, both as x, because mean is not given, both we will take as x. So we write the formula, product of means, because mean is x, so x will come on this side, in our left hand side. So product of means is equal to product of extreme. Okay, now see, x multiply by x. Now children, it will not become 2x. X multiply by x is x square, and here comes 36 into 25. Now here is x square, this is 36 into 25. So we will take the square root of this. Okay, this you can take in the form of LCM also, by making the factors also, or if you know the tables, like I know this, 6 into 6 is 36, 5 into 5 is 25. Now when we take the numbers, when we take the square root, when we take the numbers out of the square root, from these two, from the pair, we used to take a single number out. from these two 6 we will take 1 out, from these two 5 we will take 1 5 out. Now x into 5 is 30. Now again children, we want to cross check our answer. In order to cross check, what I will do, 36 multiplied 25 is how much? 900. Similarly, in my mind, I will keep this value 30. 30 multiplied by 30 is again 900. It means children, our answer is correct. Now see, if you see your books, your sixth sum is find the third term. See children, see your books, your sixth sum is find the third term. And the seventh is find the first term. And the eighth is find the value of x. See children, wherever it is written find the third term. So you have to suppose the third term x. If it is written find the first term, there you have to suppose the third term or first term x. Okay, whatever we have to find, that you have to suppose x. Okay, now the ninth one is different. So see the ninth question is, see your books. In a school library, the ratio of general knowledge means GK books to mathematics, maths books is same as the ratio of maths books to physics books. Okay, GK and maths, see I have taken here GK and maths, and they are saying maths and physics, the ratio is same. So what we will do, we will write the values, what they have given, 150 they have given GK books and 300 they have given mathematics. We have to find the number of physics books. Whatever children we have to find out, we used to write the x. So number, let number of physics books is x. So according to question, as they have given us in our question, that GK ratio maths is equal to proportionate to maths is to physics. So we will put the value 150 as given in your question, 300 is given of maths. Because maths is written twice, so same value we will write two times and is to x. Now children, my mean is 300 into 300. But where is my x? X is here in the extreme. So I will write here product of extreme is equal to product of mean. Wherever there is x, if it is in extreme, extreme will come in the left hand side. If it is in mean, mean will come in the left hand side. Okay, now I will find the value x. X is 300 multiplied by 300 divided by 150. 0, 0 cancel. 15 into 1 is 15. 15 into 2 is 30. Now 300 multiplied by 2 is 600. Now again children, question arises whether my answer is correct or not. In order to cross check, again I will put the value of 600 here. Okay, in my mind just. I will not write down here. In my mind I will put here. So 300 into 300 it will become 90,000. 150 multiplied by 600 it will also become 90,000. It means children, my answer is correct. I hope children, the next one two sums are related to this sum. You can do that one also. And I hope you have understood everything. Okay.